The Sabah standoff may be far from over. This morning, President Aquino said a probe is underway on violations committed by the Sultan of Sulu, Jamalul Kiram, his followers who are now in Lahad Datu, Sabah, and his collaborators. The president at the same time told Kiram while they have not yet reached the point of no return, the scenario is fast approaching. Government is also conducting a study on the Sultanate's claim on Sabah. So today we ask you, do you agree with Malacañang's actions on the Sabah standoff? Please tell us why.
Okay, sounds like there's a plan. I don't know if it's a definite plan, but the president started with still just an appeal for the people there in Sabah to come home. Let's talk about
it. A definite first step.
The most diplomatic way to start. Well, aside from the investigations, which sounded like a threat, if you don't come back home, we're going to start an investigation. Well, the investigation has started, he said. But what he's saying is, hey, there's a ship already there, and we're studying your claims, so maybe that's a good start for you to come back home. And because the whole situation could turn ugly. It could endanger the peace process with the MILF. And at the same time, it could affect our relations with Malaysia.
Absolutely. Volatile situation there.
Well, that's actually the first time the president has spoken. You know, this has been on for, I would say, I'm not mistaken, maybe about 2 weeks, possibly. And each and every time you try to get some interview with the Department of Foreign Affairs, and it's very difficult to actually get any response from them. I mean, it is what it is. Assistant Secretary Raul Hernandez really wants DFA Secretary Albert Del Rosario to be the one to discuss this. And they have been giving us, you know, little statements here and there, but this is the first time the president has spoken, and for me, for him to speak must mean a big thing, because it was just about a day, two or three days ago when they sent that humanitarian ship,
over the weekend,
to get the women and the children out of Sabah to bring them back to Sulu. So they didn't budge. So now the president says, okay, I guess it's time for me to say something here.
Right. We've been talking to Secretary Hernandez. You've been interviewing Secretary Hernandez on the show. Pinky, we're still studying. They're trying to be cautious and very careful. I completely understand why he actually speaks that way.
Because, you know, it's a very sensitive issue. It's a very, really sensitive issue. But here, for me, this is what it is. I think it really needs to be determined who owns that. Who is the rightful owner of that area. Because the rightful owner should actually be the one
living there.
Not even just living there, but to be recognized that he, she, or they actually own that piece of land.
It's just a recognition. Yeah. And that's what they're asking right now. We'll leave just as long as Malaysia says that they recognize our claim.
Right. I think, well, just to add, I think... While it's really come to our attention over the last couple of weeks, you know, as the situation has escalated, I think the situation itself has gone on since time immemorial. I think this is sort of the same situation you get to when you discuss ancestral domains and who owns what. Traditionally, there are different rules at play, particularly, specifically to cite, while you can have Sharia law versus
the justifications for the claims.
Right. And I think the moral nation and that sort of thing is a very gray area, I think, because while we want to be inclusive, at the same time we're in the middle of certain disagreements. So it's a very volatile and very gray area, and I think ultimately, diplomacy really is the way to go, and I fully understand where, you know, the politicians are coming from in their soft stepping around the issue if it does require.
Well, I was just going to chime in there. Also, I think land disputes have been going on for centuries, whether it be here in the Philippines or in other places in the world. And I think the most successful ones, whether it be at an actual like recognized Palestinian state, which came late last year, that only goes through years and years of diplomacy between governments. So it doesn't surprise me that, you know, Malacañang takes a strong stand on this and also sends out a message that we can have this opinion here, we can build a team together so that we can negotiate, but this does need to be an inter-government, very interactive discussion between the groups involved. Well, And let's see what our viewers think about this topic. Join our discussion by posting your answers to our question of the day. Do you agree with Malacañang's actions on the Sabah standoff? Tell us why. Tweet ANC Alerts and ANC Mornings. Please use the hashtag ANC Asks or post your reply on our Facebook page, ANC 24/7. You can also text REACT, space, ANC space, name, age, address, reaction to 2331 for Globe, TM and Sun, and 231 for Smart and TNT. People with disabilities